Welcome back to class. Let's plan this question. This is an ICANN question and it's short but very, very detailed. Kaduna Limited sold 15,000 units of its product at 20 naira per unit. Variable cost per unit is 15 naira. Are we there? The total fixed cost incurred is what? 9972,000. Okay, so calculate all the following: A, break even point in unit; B, break even point value on sales; C, units required to earn an income of 75,000 naira before tax. That is, how many units must we produce and sell to achieve 75,000 target profit? Number D, unit required to earn an after-tax profit of 100,000 naira. That is, how many units must we produce and sell to achieve a part of 100,000 naira when the tax rate is 40%? Last now. Units required to break even, that is your break even point in unit. Now, if your variable cost is now increased by 5% and fixed cost also was increased by 2.5%, it means that our own variable cost and fixed cost will change here. So there is a change now in the cost structure, but let's see how it goes. Solution number one, our break even. Okay, like I said, that was what always was find your CM, your CM, because it was selling price per unit, and was what variable cost per what unit. That was now 20 naira per unit, and it's what 15 naira. That will be 5 naira. Are we there? Next two, your CS word ratio 2. Okay? Let's do that now. That our C, we are what? S. Our C is what? Contribution. Are we? And it's 5 naira. 5 naira. Our S is what? The selling price. Are we? Sales. Are we? 20 naira. That will be 5 by 20. 5 by 20. It was 0.25. So having done this now, we can now furthermore. Number A, break even. Points having unit. That was your fixed cost over what contribution was margin. Okay? Our fixed cost here is what? Is what here? 972,000, and our CM is what? Is 5 naira. 972,000 by 5 naira give us 1944. We must produce and sell this unit in order to break even. Number two will be break even point in what? In value, at least in what? In sales. Break even point in value, at least sales. This how, that is, what is the value of goods we must sell, okay, to break even? That way, our fixed cost, I mean, over what? Over CX ratio. Are we there? Now, our FC, fixed cost is what? 972,000. Our CX is what? 0.25. That will be 972,000 by 0.25. That gives us 388,000. How many? It's 388,000. Okay. Number C. units required to earn an income of 75,000 naira before tax. That is, what units must we sell, okay, to achieve a target profit of what? Of 75,000 naira. That way, LC plus what? Target profit. Okay, over what? Our CM. Our CM. Here, our FC is what? HT 972,000 naira plus what? Our target profit of how much? 75,000 naira over our CM, which is what? 5 naira. 972,000 plus 75,000 by 5 naira. You must produce and sell 209,400 units. You must produce and sell this unit before you can achieve this target profit. Number D. Units required to earn an income after tax profit of what? 100,000 naira. That is, how many units must we produce and sell to achieve a target profit after tax of 100,000 naira if the tax rate is 40%? Let's say that was FC fiscus plus what? Part over 1 minus our tax rate. Like this, I mean, over what? Over CM. Over CM. Now, our FC here is what? Is 972,000. Okay? Our part here is what? Is 100,000 naira. 100,000 over 1 minus. I told you that we should always convert our tax percentage to what? To decimal. That is 40% plus what? 0.4. We have 0.4 over our CM, which is 5 naira. That will be now. That will be 972,000 plus 100,000 by what? 1 minus 0.4 will give you what? 0.6. So you say 100,000 divided by what? 0.6. It give us 166667 over what? 5 plus 972,000 plus 166667 by 5. It give us 227,733 units. We must produce and sell this unit to achieve a profit after tax of 100,000 naira. Now, the last one now, number 5. E. Please pay a rapt attention here. Here. Now, question E. Calculate the units required to break even if variable cost is now increased by 5% and the fixed cost too increased by 2.5%. Here we are saying that there is now a change in the cost structure. So if our variable cost is now increased and fixed cost is increased, what is the unit you must produce and sell to break even? You must understand that if you have this kind of question, okay, you are going to adjust the old variable cost of 15 naira and the old fixed cost of what? Of 972,000 naira. So let's see how it goes. Here you say, calculate first, revise revised variable cost. It is called revised because what? We are altering, we are changing the old variable cost out there. Now, that will be 100 plus what? Plus 5% increase. Plus 5 increase, okay? Aha, it will come up. Over what? Over 100 times the old variable cost, which is what? 15 naira. Our times 15 naira. Now, this will give us what? 105, right? Over what? Over 100, okay? Times what? 15. That will give us 105 times 15 by 100. Give us 15.75. As you can see here, that's what being what increased by 75 kobo out there. Two, our revised fixed cost out there. Fixed cost. We are told that our fixed cost too is also what increased by 2.5. Are we? Aha. That will be 102 plus what? 2.5 over 100 times what? The original fee cost, which is 972,000. That will be 100 plus 2.5, right? Aha. Times 972,000 by 100. You now give us here 996,300. This is what our new fee cost. Therefore, break even point now, okay, in units will be revised fee cost over contribution what margin. Okay. So our revised fee cost is now what? Is now 996. Are we there? 300 over our CM. Our CM is now what? It's not the selling price. I mean, per unit, which is what? 20 naira. Are we there? 20 naira. And as what? Our new variable cost 15.75. That will 996,300 over 20 minus 15.75 give us 4.25 out there. So let's now 996,300 by 4.25. We give us what? 23234. Okay, 424 units. That is, we must produce and sell this unit in order to break even. This is the end of this ICAM adapted question. Thank you very much. Like I said earlier, should you have any question, don't be shy, okay, to contact us, okay, through our contact list via the phone call or WhatsApp, our Gmail, whichever, okay? We are always there, okay, to listen to your questions, and let's have the same understanding as we go ahead in this class. Thank you. God bless you. See you in the next class.